This is Prashant, and I am the lead of the engineering effort here in pCloudy. Today, I am here to do a few demos of how you do Android DevOps using Jenkins and pCloudy. This session would last approximately 30 minutes, and at the end of this session, you will understand how you could use Jenkins along with pCloudy using a mobile app testing solution like Appian, and how you can achieve DevOps on a mobile platform using these three tools. So without much ado, let's go ahead and start the presentation. So here's the agenda. So I'll start up by telling you what pCloudy is, and you know, for those who do not already know, I'll give you a brief introduction of what pCloudy is, what are our services, what do we help the market with. After that, I would go and explain how CA works, especially in the mobile application domain. Then I would throw some light on the difficulties of using CI, especially in the mobile domain. Also, I'll explain where we come in and what pCloudy does that can make your work in DevOps easier. After that, I would be attempting a live demo of how you would run DevOps using pCloudy and Jenkins. And finally, I'll explain to you how this is all of value to you. And once that is done, I would open the field for questions, so that if anybody of you have questions, then I can answer those questions. So let's dive right in. So this is what overall pCloudy looks like. At its heart, pCloudy is a device cloud. We host devices on the cloud in our many data centers. You can access those devices which would be present in remote data centers. You can access those devices using the web browser, and you can test practically everything that you would have tested using a device that is in your hands. You can access us through web. You can access us through plugins on Android Studio or Xcode. And as I'm going to show today, you can access us using Jenkins also. You can do manual testing using the platform. You could do automation testing. You could also retrieve analytics of the device, including performance metrics and metrics of CPU, battery, and other such performance metrics while you're doing the testing. And with our newest acquisition, that is Cloud for Testing, we have now in-field user experience testing. So these are the services that you could avail from us. Now, what are the kind of apps that we support testing of? We support testing of native apps. We support mobile web apps. We support hybrid applications. And we also support progressive web applications. We, as of right now, we have more than 500 real devices, which is the widest variety of devices among our competitors and is the best in class variety of devices that we offer. Many of these devices have real SIMs, and so you could do testing of calls, of messaging, of operator related things, or stuff that is related to operator network. You could test all that. Our devices are located at four locations across the world. One in Bangalore. There's a data center in Bangalore. There is a data center in California. We have one in Sydney, and there is one in Philippines. So all this is about our public cloud, but we operate in a few other business models also. So the most popular business model that we operate under is the public cloud. The public cloud is what you would see when you log in at www.pcloudy.com. Here you can sign up, and on sign up you could get 60 minutes of free access at the beginning, and once those 60 minutes are up, there are so many subscription plans that you could avail of, and there are so many subscription plans that you could avail of, and you could use the devices as per your needs and your requirements. So this was the public cloud. We have another business model that is the private cloud. A private cloud is a smaller and a more exclusive instance of the public cloud. It's very similar to the public cloud, as in it is hosted by us, and we connect the devices to it, and you know, it is in our premises, but it is exclusively for the use of your company, if your company happens to be our private cloud customer. So you have very high device availability, because it's only the people of your company that will be using those devices. So device availability is not a problem, and because this device is for the use of your company, you can have near unlimited use of those devices, at least till the time you are our customer. So this is the biggest advantage of a private cloud. You get exclusivity and unhindered access for the devices. We also have a third business model, which we call the on-premise cloud. So this is similar to the private cloud. The only difference is, as the name suggests, it is in your premises. And since it is in your premises, there is more flexibility that you could have. Typically, pCloudy supports mobile phones, but if you have any other devices which you would want to connect to your cloud, it can be done if it is in a non-premise setup. Your devices can be connected. It need not be mobile phones. It could be something else also. And as I have said just now, with the on-premise cloud, you would have more control and more flexibility over the cloud. And just like private cloud, you will have unhindered device availability and practically unlimited usage of those devices. And mind you, these devices are both mobile phones and devices that are not mobile phones. So this was a kind of an introduction of what we are and what we do and how you could avail of our services. Now we go to the purpose of this discussion, and that is to be able to run a continuous integration using Android, continuous integration based DevOps using Jenkins and pCloudy for Android. So what is continuous integration, and why is it such a big thing? So CI, or continuous integration as it is known, is a process by which the developer can keep adding code to his system. As soon as he has tested whatever he has implemented, he can push it to whatever source control you are using. And continuous integration allows you to be able to build that code and automatically integrate that code with the rest of the system, and also do some kind of automated verification in terms of has the build passed in languages that are compiled, like Java or C++. You could also go ahead and do tests on those systems. Those tests could be unit tests, those could be integration tests, those could be any other kind of tests. Whatever that is automatable can be done using a continuous integration, and this enables that at every point of the development cycle, nothing breaks. Whenever something breaks, by its very nature, the system alerts you with alarms or statuses that something has broken, and then you can go back and fix it. So your system is not only being continuously integrated, it's also being continuously improved, and bugs or any other system stability issues are continuously taken care of and continuously notified to you so that you can fix them. One very famous continuous integration tool is Jenkins. Jenkins is world renowned for its continuous integration abilities, and it is used by practically everyone. In fact, so much so that Jenkins has become a de facto provider of continuous integration service. Jenkins at the very core, Jenkins is a task manager. So you can give it a set of tasks, and then you can tell it how you want those tasks to be done. Overall, Jenkins is just that. So you could tell it whatever sequence you want to run it in. You can tell it what configurations it needs to take, where it needs to take tasks from, how it needs to do the tasks, when it needs to do tasks, and when it needs to wait for a trigger to be able to do the tasks. So that is what Jenkins does. Jenkins automates because of all these abilities, you can use Jenkins to automate builds, and as I mentioned before, you can also use it to automate tests. While there are quite a few such tools in the market, where Jenkins really scores is the fact that it's unbelievably flexible, and at the same time, it is very simple, and a very huge number of people can learn Jenkins very soon. Jenkins is also pretty robust and pretty reliable. So now going on, let me throw some light on what are the difficulties that you would face while running continuous integration, especially in the mobile domain. So one of the prime objectives of continuous integration is that it has to be continuous, and it has to be stable, and it has to be running without human interaction for quite a long time. But mobiles being mobiles, or mobile phones being mobile phones, are something that can be very easily disconnected and can be taken away very easily. Also, most of the mobiles that are used these days are smartphones. So many times they seem to have a mind of its own and may not behave exactly the same way as your servers would behave. Also, mobiles are built for a different purpose. Some mobiles are not even permissive enough to allow many of the controls that you wanted to. Many of the controls and constraints that you wanted to operate under. So many times having a Jenkins setup to run on mobile is like trying to connect two different worlds. Typically, you have seen that Jenkins is very popular in the enterprise world, in the enterprise software solutions world, whereas while it is very popular in the mobile world also, it's not as popular there. On the other hand, Appium is something that is very popular in the mobile world. So using Appium or any other such mobile application testing tools and trying to connect it to Jenkins is like connecting two different worlds, where you try to connect the enterprise software solutions world to the mobile world, to the static services, to the mobile phone world. So these are two different worlds in many dimensions, and we are trying to connect two different worlds. And the other difficulty that one might face while trying to do a CI on in the mobility industry is that many times one phone simply is not enough. You might test something on one phone and find it satisfactory, but that doesn't mean that what your return works on every other phone in the market. This market is so fragmented that you have to test on multiple phones to factor in for different form factors, for different CPU architectures, for different operating systems, and so on and so forth. Also, there is no standard framework that you can use that allows you to do a proper CI on mobile phones. There are frameworks here and there that attempt to solve problems from a particular viewpoint but there are not enough robust and reliable standard frameworks in the market that you can use to achieve CI on mobile. And here is where pCloudy comes in. One, because we have 500 devices in one place where you can actually do your testing. So what we have essentially done is we have commoditized the mobile phones, and you can choose any one of our of the phones in our vast array of phones, and you will be charged only for the amount of minutes that you use those phones. You do not need to own the phone, you don't need to rent the phones, and you do not need to physically think about the hassle of connecting those phones to your continuous integration system. Now that I have said that, you don't have to worry about the hassle of being able to connect those phones to our continuous integration system, you would wonder how else are we trying to you know, automate your CI using Jenkins. So here we have a Jenkins plugin. The pCloudy Jenkins plugin allows you to you know, run many automations, including Appium. So we have Appium, Espresso, we have Monkey. So these are the things that we can run, and you know, these all can be run using the pCloudy Jenkins plugin. Today I will be showing you how you could run an Appium test on using pCloudy devices using the Jenkins continuous integration framework. So before I go into the actual demo, let me just explain to you what will be demoed. So first I'll just go through the configurations that I have done on Jenkins so that I can explain to you how this works. I have created a small Android project. It's a small Hello World project using Android Studio and Gradle. So what I would do is I would do some changes in the Android Studio code and commit it to Git. Once it is committed to Git, then I'll start the build on Jenkins. In the real world, what would happen is Jenkins would wait for some time, and you know, it has a periodic check by at which time it can download. But in just for the sake of brevity in this demo, I would be directly triggering a build in Jenkins. So what this build is configured to do is it does two things. One is it builds your Android code to make sure that you're, you know, there are no errors or any such thing. And so that is one. And two, what it does is it the APK that got created after you have done the build gets uploaded to pCloudy, and a small Appium test gets run on that. And then at the end of it, it tells you what you know, what has passed and what has failed, and you know, it tells you the performance metrics like CPU or memory or battery usage and all the stuff while the tests were being run. So that is overall what I would be showing to you. Let me summarize again. I'll show you the configurations first, then I'll show you the Android project in which we would be doing which we'll be showing how many people, how we would be doing the test, how we'll be running the code and changing the code. And once the code is changed and pushed to Git, I'll show you how Jenkins pulls the code down. I'll also be showing how the Jenkins plugin, what changes you need to do in the Jenkins plugin for Appium on pCloudy, and then I'll show you the entire build. Simultaneously, we'll also see a live view in pCloudy of the test being run. And once the test is run, you'll see the report of the test, and which concludes, which also shows what has passed, what has failed, and what are the performance metrics. So without much ado, let's jump in. Okay, so I hope I'm able to see, I hope you are able to see the screen. One sec, yeah. So this is the Android Studio screen that I have opened. I hope all of you are able to see the screen. So what I do is I will just go ahead and write a small comment into the code and save it. Then let me go ahead and commit this to Git. So in Git, I'll say commit the file. I'll put a comment that says okay, and then I go ahead and I commit and push the file. And yeah, here is the final confirmation. So the Android Studio does some work, and then finally it says, hey, push one commit to the origin. All right, so let us go back to Jenkins. So here is my Jenkins plugin. I'll just show you what is happening in Jenkins. So this is how I have configured the project. I have I have given it my GitHub URL. There's the URL that I put there. I have also given it my credentials. I have told it to look at this particular branch. So this is a single branch plugin. If you use a multi-branch plugin, you would select all the branches that you want to run it on. I've asked it to poll every 2 minutes, but probably I'll run the build before that. Here is a location in my machine of where the Git project is, or where the Android project is. And this is the Gradle task I wanted to run. If you haven't seen, I'm trying to use the Gradle wrapper. So that's that. And then this is required for running the pCloudy tests on pCloudy itself. So this is the URL of pCloudy.com. In most cases, it would be the public IP. This is the public URL or the URL of a public cloud. If you happen to be using a private cloud, you would be using that URL. This is the user ID and API key for that particular URL. This is the CLI path for the Appium connector that would be running to run an Appium test case. So we have made it into a jar. So this has a test case and Appium connector and all that together. This has been made into a jar. And this I have passed as a CLI, which would be called to the command line. This is the path of the completed application that gets created once Jenkins does the previous step of building. And the duration is the duration for which we have booked the device. We would need to book a device on pCloudy to be able to run the tests. You can select any number of devices based on Android versions and based on the Android operating system version, and you have so many devices. I have, if you would see, pre-selected two devices, and I would be running the tests on those devices. So that's all there is to it. So I go back, I say build now. Oh, the build seems to have already started. Great. So I'll go to the console output. So as you're seeing, the build has finished successfully and it started to do the Appium test. Let's see if we can capture an Appium test running here. So if you go to reports, okay, let me log in again. Yeah, there you go. We have logged in. Let me go to devices. I'll go to reports, and in the reports you would be seeing active sessions. So this would be an active session because as per Jenkins, the build is now running. So this would be an active session. Just let's wait for the sessions to load. And there you go. You have loaded. I'll just click on the live view. So this utility allows you to see live on all the devices that have been tested. As I showed you before, I had selected two devices and the tests are being run on those two devices. We came in a bit late because I had to log out, but you can see the tests are actually being run right now on one of the phones, the second phone, the test actually seems to have finished. So that is that. Let's see what Jenkins is doing. So for the purposes of this demo and to factor in for situations like this, we had configured the demo to run twice, or the tests of Appium to run twice. So you would see the tests are starting again now here. Give it a few seconds. Yeah, there it is. So this is just a simple test that launches the application and tries a few things like scrolling up and shuts it down. It's a very simple use case. In the real world, the use cases would be slightly more complicated than that. And yeah, the live view closed because the tests have finished. Now you could go to all your reports and you can see the latest reports of what happened. So this is the latest report of the session that was run at a few minutes back. So let us see what happened there. So there it's telling you that the test ran on two devices and it has been executed on two devices. These are the two devices on which the test ran. So one is Motorola Moto E3 Power and the other one is Samsung Galaxy S6. So let me open Samsung Galaxy S6. So here you see the name of the session and you know various data about what kind of phone it is. And this is the performance data that I was talking to you about. It tells you how the battery was used during the session. This is this also tells you how much memory was used at various times during the session. The same goes for what was the pattern of CPU usage during the entire session. How well or not so well was frame rendering happening? Was there any network usage? This particular application didn't have any network usage, so there are none. If the Appium script was configured to take screenshots at that particular time, you would have seen some screenshots here. So, and at the end of it, there is a video of all that happened. So whatever you would have seen in the live view that I showed just now, you would also have see a video of that particular activity here. So that's all that we have. So this entire test suite you have. Apart from that, if you look at the Jenkins report, it also puts a report at this location in your Jenkins machine. You can pick it up from there and you can see a detailed report of what all tests were run and which ones passed and which ones failed. So as you can see here, the execution has been completed and the entire Jenkins job has completed successfully. So that is what I wanted to show to you. So this is all that I have with me. We will soon be sharing data about where to find the pCloudy Jenkins plugin and where do you get the sample projects and how do you create an Appium project that you can use with the pCloudy Jenkins plugin. We'll be sharing all the data soon. And that brings our demo to an end. So let me go back to my PowerPoint. So what is the value that is there in this for you? The primary value that you have is CI by default, especially in the mobile demo or in the mobile world, is pretty hassleful. And what you achieve here is you have a hassle-free CI. As you saw, the CI itself ran very smoothly. It took the code from Git and it built it successfully. It then started the Appium tests on the device. It booked, it uploaded the completed APK into the into device.pcloudy. It ran Appium tests on it. You got the entire gamut of performance tests, performance metrics like CPU, battery, memory, and stuff like that. Or you also were able to see a report that told you which what all passed and what all failed, all in the course of a demo. Mind you, I have given this live demo, and this is not a video, so it is that hassle-free and it works that well. Your tests are more reliable because every time you commit some code into your source control, a build happens, and if you have written your tests for Appium completely and if your code coverage is very good, you can be absolutely sure that a lot of your code works exactly as you had designed it. So this gives you a huge coverage of your code and ability to run your code and run your tests run your tests on all parts of your code. And because you are using pCloudy, you have the ability to use a lot of phones using the pCloudy Jenkins plugin, which offers a seamless device connectivity to the whole CI process. So that's all that I have for this time. If you have any questions, can you please ask those questions to me?
Thank you.
Okay, I got a question asking what if the devices are already busy? So this is a very valid question. In case of a public cloud, what will happen is it is very highly likely that a lot of people will be using the devices that you wanted to test on. So what I usually recommend people is to have, is to prepare your tests in such a way that these tests run on multiple devices. Like in the case that I just showed you, I had selected two devices and luckily the test ran on both the devices. But if the devices were busy, the setup will tell you that the devices were not available and tests could not be run on those particular devices. But to ensure that your tests ran somewhere, the best course of action is to make sure that you have selected two or more devices so that the chance of none of the devices that you wanted being available is very less. Your tests would run on at least one of the devices that you have selected if some of the others are busy. Another question is how much network lag do you get? So as you have seen right now, I have used the public cloud and the public cloud access is over the internet, which means technically the access speed and lag due to internet speed is the highest, and as you have seen, there has been no significant lag in the device, in the connectivity to device, and in running of the test. Where you might see some kind of lag is the place where you upload the executable to the cloud, and also sometimes if you try to take screenshots, those kind of things might be a bit slow. But apart from that, there is no real lag. Of course, the performance will not match the case where a device is actually connected to your machine, because this is not the case. The device is physically present in a remote location and you are connecting to that device through the internet. So there will be some lag because of this, but as you saw right now, the lag was not too much. In fact, the test started far before we even anticipated it to run. So yeah, that's that. Are there any more questions? All right, it seems that there are no more questions. So thanks a lot, everyone, for spending time.